Ashes. Hi vloggers!
Hi vloggers!
That's just a little bit of Sheryl Crow. A change will do you good. The very best of Sheryl Crow.
Jason is not only producing the vlog, he is the audio, he's the cameraman running back and forth.
You know.
And costumer.
And costumer.
And major. And your major.
So, lots of work. We're busy, busy bees.
I know. Actually, you're a very, very busy bee. I've been busy, but now it's mostly kind of sitting in your lap now.
Well, I'm trying to get it done.
Yeah. It's fun stuff, though, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
I'm enjoying the Christmas stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. What was called our grand, Santa's grand entrance has gotten a little bigger, so.
It's fun.
It is. It's very exciting. And the rally thing that we're doing is also fun up there. But anyway,
that song goes out to
Ryan?
Yes.
Right, okay. First it's Wednesday, October 24th, 2007. We don't have the computer open, but not soon enough till George W. Bush leaves office. But I was checking Ryan's blog, Ryan A's. And he updates it, I don't know, every sixth year or something. But I noticed that he was talking about the fact that after quite a few years, I guess now, that he's worked at King's Dominion, he kind of thinks that next week is the week that he's moving, he's going to be moving on and doing other things. And that's always tough, to leave that job that is that special job that you just love.
Yeah, well, and I guess you have to look at it as, you know, it's hard at the time, but then, you know, once you've had a little bit of time away from it, I don't know, you have a fondness for it in your heart, and it's always there, it never changes.
You have to do it, too. You have to move on.
It's good for you, like Sheryl Crow was just a singing. A change will do you good.
You feel that way about your years at Great Adventure. Where? Six Flags.
Six Flags.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was great fun.
Yeah. I felt that way about my couple of years as a tour guide at Universal. I loved that job. And even when I think back on it now, in fact, I think back on it probably even more romantically than it was, but I did love that job. But I understand, Ryan, and, you know, it's been, I'm sure other opportunities will come up, but you've done a great job up there at King's Dominion, and job well done, sir.
Yeah, hear, hear!
Move on with your head held high and move on to other things. Speaking of some folks in the Nickelodeon world, Ernestine is going to be visiting. She's going to come in and do, they did this last year.
A stint.
Yeah, she's going to spend the Christmas holidays at the Nick Hotel. And she will fill in the entertainment department.
That's going to be so much fun.
It is. It's great. I'm happy for the audience because Ernestine is a marvelous performer and the kids will enjoy her. And I think Ernestine will enjoy the experience as well. Good for everyone involved. Ernestine, we don't have anything to rehearse. We're not going to be down there.
We won't see you, but we won't be there for any particular reason.
But we'll find a way to get down. In fact, I want to catch up. I need to go back and see some shows and stuff.
And
so
we're away when she gets here, so.
Yeah, we get back on like around November 11th or 12th, something like that. But in any event, we will make a visit down and we'll get to see some. So we're looking forward to your visit, Ernestine, and I'm excited for you as well.
Yes.
Hello to Adele. She sent a MySpace. I don't always return MySpace comments.
I don't either. She sent me one too and I didn't respond.
Hi, Adele.
Hi, Adele.
What about these forest fires in California?
It's very sad. But the one thing I will say is that it sounds like at the arena where they have everything set up, it sounds very organized, very set up. They're not really missing a, you know, it sounds like they're really sort of taking every action to address helping these people, and they already have people there filling out information to get the, you know, relief that they need and the money that they need and things like that. There's food, there's yoga, there's stuff to take care of the kids. So,
yeah.
You know, as horrible as it is, at least it sounds like
we've learned from our lessons.
Yes.
Our lessons. Yeah.
Yeah, we sure have.
Very sad for those folks.
It still doesn't change how horrible that must be for them.
Yeah. George Carlin was saying some really tough things on The View this morning, commenting about some of that. Some I kind of agree with, some I don't. But it was interesting seeing him.
But
George Carlin,
when people start talking like that, it's hard for people to take it.
It is. I mean, some of what he was saying is a little hard to take. It's hard to face some of that stuff. But I just think it's interesting how that guy went from being this hippie of the 60s to this 70-year-old curmudgeon. I mean, he's kind of a little, like, he's one step away from Andy Rooney.
Well, yeah, I
but
guess.
I always found George Carlin funny. Evidently, he just came out with this big DVD set, which I wouldn't mind seeing some of those.
No, is it good?
Because that was some funny stuff.
Oh, so they have a law out. Well, it comes out every so often. You hear about it in different...
An attempt to make something.
An attempt to make a new law about kids that run around with their pants about this low below their underwear, so you see their undies hanging out. And they try to make it a law, but as much as I don't like it, which, you know, believe me, I think it's just as, you know...
You have issues about people dressing oddly?
Well, no. I have indecent exposure in showing, you know, too much of someone's underwear or the tea back of a thong. It's just a little much.
You know what?
And people... But I don't think our government should be out there to regulate things like that. Let's focus on real issues and things that will get, you know, health care, all those things. Let's focus on real things that matter besides... how high people's pants are, higher low.
Well, I agree with that, and on top of that, I have to say that I think that this is a battle that has gone on for generation after generation. Any young generation coming up is going to do something that's going to try to push the buttons of the older generation to get their attention, to rebel, to be different than other people. And I say, drop your drawers, fellas, I don't care. But it looks very uncomfortable to me. I would feel like I would be going crazy. I couldn't walk around like that. As it is, I feel like that, because I got this big belly, you see. So now, if I drop my pants beyond my belly, I got no booty. So the drawers then go all the way down to the ankles, you see. So I could never be cool like the fellas and the young ladies can, but... you know, if I had a bootylicious booty, I'd let my drawers hang.
I think we have just shared too much information with some people, but...
Well, everyone knows. Rebecca was coming, we were talking about the,
Haunted Mystery...
Yeah, we were talking about Most Haunted Live, and Rebecca commented on another show that's, I forget what network...
Sci-Fi.
Yeah, Taps. That was on another network.
Ghost Hunters or something.
Yeah, but that was
Is it on like Discovery?
It was on something it moved to there, but that's great. They're like Roto-Rooter guys.
Yeah, they're great.
And
the bald-headed guy looks like Mr. Clean.
Yeah. But what's funny about all these shows is they do all of this investigation and there's all this speculation, but never anything other than a couple
of wolves. No, sometimes they, like the Taps guys have shown like, you'll see down at the long end of a hallway, you'll see like a faint image of, looks like someone walking by, and they have it on video. I don't know.
I love that.
It's fun.
It's hysterical.
So.
Again, we're still recording from the video camera, and as the Kevin Miller, who doesn't have a sarcastic bone in his body,
yeah, we're now recording off of the video camera, and then we're going to upload it into the computer so that there's no more whatever, all that stuff.
Kevin, I couldn't watch it either. It was one of the... I always like watching our vlog, but I couldn't watch that one. It was annoying. It was like...
Sorry.
It was weird, because you was like... Whenever, like, you start to pixelate, it reminds me of one of those movies...
Max Headroom?
Yeah, something like that, where they're just kind
Ooh,
of...
Max Headroom, good
...taking
Lord,
you away.
Reference.
Yeah, it is a good 80s reference.
Got about 45 seconds.
So we'll try to stay on top of things. We have a busy couple of days planning to get head up to Atlanta. When we're up there, I'm sure we're going to visit with family in Atlanta. We're looking forward to it. We've got some fun things to do. First, this rally that we're doing, which is weird because I'm actually going to be hosting it. And then, weird only because I haven't done it in a while. And then we're putting up the Christmas parade that they're now calling it. At the Rock. And then by the time we come back from that, it's Christmas.
right.
Anyway, for now, happy Halloween. We'll talk to you guys tomorrow.
Have a great day, guys. Bye!